investor space, and do you work with the team?
So let me explain a bit about investor space. And so in 2019 December also, I had another moment, and we thought, why not teach? I was in my final year, why not teach people how to invest and get them to become very financially literate? And we started a club with my friends, Samuel, my brother Clement, a lady called Wangoi, Faisal, and we started a club, investors club in the same, became very active. And then Corona happened. And I was like, let me, all this I've learned in the last 3 years, extreme research, numbers, I'd invested in 2018, let me teach it to someone at a very cheap price. So we started the investor space, where you teach someone the details from the knowing what are shares and everything, how the market works, going through analysis, valuations, research, everything about the market from beginning to the end. And it's now, we serve people through helping them to save at a good interest rate of 8.5%. And then for the shares class, the investor space, you learn and get to learn, you get contacts, how to open your own investment account, legitimate brokerage companies. You learn how to invest, how to hold your companies, how to look at market analysis, so that you're fully prepared to invest. And everyone who's joined the class, I remember when I started the class, it was fully refundable, because I wasn't sure if people would love it. And guys were so happy, no one, not even one single person asked for a refund. And so I continued increasing it and improving it as I studied. And right now we are a team of three, and now it's getting better and better and better. There's more value, there's more content, and we're just growing.
Right. From where you seated and when you guys started, when look at the Save Women Awewe and also the investor space, what is the market gap that you saw when it comes to whatever you're doing? And what is your target market, by the way?
My target market is youth.
Okay.
And there's power in numbers. You see, we were doing some numbers, and you see, if 50 youths, just 50, contribute 100 bucks per week, in an entire year, they'll have saved over 200,000. That's the power of raising capital together. And so I realized youth have money. People go out a lot, people spend a lot, people buy a lot of amazing clothes, people buy a lot of everything. But then we don't invest, and more so we don't invest in our own country, where there are amazing companies and amazing opportunities. And so that's my market, that's my target market, because the youth have opportunities that they don't realize, they have capital that they can utilize, and they also, I also want the youth to grow their finances and their futures. And yes.
All right. Then that's actually an impressive and actually a good way to go about it. But let's look at the situation about, we have young people who are not privileged enough to gain this financial literacy, or even not background in finance, that is, or even people who can help them out, and they're dealing with pressure from when it comes to just financial aspect of it, pressure like when it comes to education, maybe feel like I need to take another degree, or even family matters. There's also the pressure of, you know, marriage, or just taking care of your family back at home. So how do you balance that when it comes to saving or even investment when you're going on the field and just talking to these young people?
I know it's tough. Some people have it rough. But then the most important thing is for you to have a good plan. For you to have a good plan and utilize the opportunities. And that's the way you can be able to better handle your situations. You see, saving even 100 bob a week or even 50 bob, it grows over time. And I know it's tough for people, but then one is they need to really have a good plan, to know the opportunities. You see, when you invest in shares, it's passive. Once you buy shares, forget about them, and you can focus on you being a journalist, and you keep on working. And that way, you can even have extra income to supplement some other needs. And once you grow and realize these opportunities, people can make careers out of it through investment, can make careers out of it. They can put an investment and it grows for them. I mean, people who got enriched through the stock market, because it's where buyers and sellers meet, and you get to invest in wonderful companies. So it's opportunity. Sometimes investment is a luxury for some, but then the goal is, even if you're in a tough position, try to work hard and get to a point where you can invest, and multiply your money.
And speaking about investment being a luxury to some people, even the mentality of, because when you think about investment, look about probably investing in real estate. Most people think that way. So probably you could break it down for us when it comes to investment. What sort of opportunities are there for young people?
You see, the thing is, for you to buy Safaricom shares, you only need 3,700 bob. For you to buy cooperative shares, you only need 1,200 shillings. So see, investment is not expensive. I told someone I had shares in Safaricom, and they was like, are you Chris Kirubi? Mm-hmm. And you see, it's cheap.
Okay.
But then, the thing is, one, you can invest in shares, great companies, right. Safaricom, EABL, Centum, and you can also invest in digital currencies like Bitcoin and
money markets.
Yeah, and Ethereum. You can invest in money markets where they invest for you. You can invest in you can also invest in gold in the stock market in Kenya. Do you know that? Mm-hmm. You can actually invest in gold. You don't have to buy a gold watch, invest, land in an apartment somewhere. You can actually buy shares in gold tomorrow morning on the
So support. Would you say that it all falls under building capacity and also financial literacy, so that we can building capacity, knowing what actually matters pertaining finance and everything, so that you can, you know, young people can access this information that you have?
Yes. Yes, there are so many opportunities to invest. You can invest in a small business, you can invest in your friend, you know, maybe as a PS place. Mm-hmm. You can invest in that. So the thing is to understand all the investment opportunities around you and so you can utilize some of them.
Okay.
Yes.
All right, so with access to different apps that actually lend loans and young people just having this particular opportunity, so when would you say it's the right time to go for a loan or even borrow, consider that most of young people actually they're running away from, you know, paying these particular loans because, you know, the installments, they skyrocket and be like.
For me, I'd say don't take these mobile loans. They have very high interest rates. They'll deplete your money and you'll have a lot of pressure. I'd say if you can, try avoid these small loans. It's better to go for maybe a bank loan or at a cheaper rate or from a relative. That at cheaper rates, because these mobile loans, they have risk, because many people don't pay them. And so for these companies to account for this risk, they charge very high rates. You can be paying 15% every month, to mean that in 6 months, you're paying almost the entire amount.
But one can argue that, you know, like I can borrow from this particular app and move to another. I don't have to really like actually held accountable, because it's, you know, it's easy, it's flexible.
It's not prudent, mm-hmm. One. It's not, the numbers don't make sense. And also, there's no ethics in, because you'll be put in on CRB and
true.
In the next 5 years, you cannot take a loan.
Because of
being cheeky. Yes.
So when it comes to the club that you guys have, when it comes to the investment space, who is eligible to be part of you guys?
Anyone. Anyone who wants to learn about shares and investment and to be guided on how to look at companies, how to analyze a company, how to research, how to various investment strategies and everything. Anyone is eligible. The class is only 1,000 bob. I made it very cheap for over 50 contents of material, 3 investment books. You can ask any questions, give you contacts for my brokerage company so that you can open an account. It show you how to invest for yourself, and you can even ask me what I've invested in and I tell them. So it's anyone, and it's I've had old guys and I've also had young guys, I think from 16 to about maybe 32. So anyone can join if they want to learn. It's a very wonderful class. It's live and it's just amazing.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And for someone who's watching this conversation and they're wondering, oh, they are interested actually to be on the other side of where you are, who is actually running the show when it comes to finance. They have like probably information about finance and they want to start off similar kind of a business. So what would be your advice?
I'd say there's a lot of opportunity. Just need to, fortune favors the bold. You just need to start. Get something. You see, if you're offering someone value, offer it to someone, make it a business, because business is value, it creates value. And so if you feel like you can advise someone, you can actually help someone invest, you can actually help someone manage their money, maybe keep them accountable, give them a financial plan, when you start that, you can even help people pay their taxes, you can help people like do their KRA, is it remittances or something. Mm-hmm. There's so much you can do. You can help people do accounting for their business. So start, ask people, do you want this? The best way to do is to ask and to offer it, and if people love it, go fully with it.
All right, and the most effective delivery channels that you use to reach out to the young people?
So for me, you can follow me on Instagram at Clarence_Mukoro. You can also follow the investor space on Instagram, our page that is, we started recently, the_investors_space. I'm on Facebook under Clarence, called Clarence Solomon. And my number is 0756-490-192. 0756-490-192.
What's the future looking like when it comes to the investor space?
The future is great and it's bright. And I just pray that God blesses us so much so that we can impact as many people. Mm-hmm. And then we really want to get bigger and better and get as many people to invest when they're young, because the results show. If I can give a story, when Safaricom started in 2008, one share was going for 5 shillings. And our president, our former president Kibaki, bought 1 million shares. Mm-hmm. So he used 5 million. So 1 million shares at 5 shillings per share, 5 million. Right now, Safaricom is at 37. And so that his worth is now at 7 million. But over those 12 years, he's gotten dividends of about 14. 14 times 1 million shares, another 14 million. That's about 51 million. And if he compounded his shares, meaning if he got his dividends and he bought more shares, it would be worth over 60 million. So 5 million to over 60 million in a period of maybe 12 years. That shows even ways you can grow your wealth over time. He just bought them and he's now maybe playing golf or talking to his grandkids or anything.
Traveling the world.
Yeah, so that's the power of investment. It's good to start now. We have time. And what I can tell young guys is fortune favors the bold. Our choices today really determine our future. So go there, take on risk, think big, and try your best.
All right, thank you very much, Clarence Mukoro, for creating time to be with us.
Thank you so much, Michelle.
You're very much welcome. So that is Clarence Mukoro, and we were talking about understanding youth and their financial needs, and I hope you have learned one or two, three things when it comes to matters pertaining finance and actually investing. At Y254 channel is where you can find us across all our social media handles. At Michelle Ashira is where you can find me across all my socials. So